Toastmasters, all of us have heard some of the other story of so many inspirational people. And a lot of stories in your circle as well, with a good salary, good house, good car, good partner. A lot of other stories that you might hear again. Today, I'm going to share you one story where a person achieved so many things after losing everything. The story is Karolyi Tanaks. He is a Hungarian. He was in the Hungarian army in the year of 1936. He was the best shooter of the world. The only thing that he was lacking in that he was a sergeant and not a rank officer in the army. In 1936, the Olympics were about to held, but he wasn't allowed to participate because he was a sergeant. And sergeants were not allowed to participate in the Olympics too. But soon after this Olympic was done, this rule was lifted up, the prohibition was lifted up. And now everybody in the army was aiming Karolyi to win the 1940 Olympics. The qualifications started in 1938 across the world, and everybody hoped that Karolyi Tanaks will qualify. Just months before of this qualification round, there was a tampered bearing which burst in his right hand, and the right hand was shattered. Now imagine. This was the best shooting hand of the world, which shattered down. It was not just the hand which shattered on that day, but the dream of a man who win the Olympics also shattered. You have two options now, whether he can give up or keep trying. He asked this question to himself, why me? And a lot of others will ask, all of us will ask about the same, why me? He was the best shooting man, but now his dream is gone. What he did is, soon after recovering from the injury, he started secretly practicing the shoot. It's very severe. Now, after the qualification happened, in 1939, the Hungarian army again announced for a wild card entry if anybody is still willing to participate for the 1940 Olympics. And Karolyi showed up. Everybody in the army was coming to him and giving sympathy. Oh, I'm sorry, you couldn't participate in this because you are injured. I know what he told. I'm not here to participate, buddy. I'm here to fight against all of you. Because he has been practicing. Now think for a moment how this person will participate in a shattered hand. You know what happened? When this man walked to the target area and was about to aim the bullseye and about to pick up a gun, everybody was hoping that this man will pick the gun from right hand. But no. Secretly, he was practicing shooting. Not from the best hand, but the only hand he had, the left hand. And he picked the gun from the left hand. And within seconds, he just shoot, boom, boom. All the shots were there, on the bullseye, and everybody was shot. Everybody was picking guns from their best hand, but this man was picking the gun from the only hand. And then he did not ask why, he said, try. Soon everybody started jabbing, everybody was very amused to see, wow, we are back in the army and we'll win. The Hungary will win the shooting championship of 1940 Olympics. But to his surprise, the intensity of disaster didn't end just right here. 1940 Olympics were cancelled due to World War II. This man's dream was about to shatter. So he waited for next 4 years and he hoped that in 1944 I'll again participate in shooting and I'll win it. But to his surprise again, the 1944 Olympics were again cancelled due to the continuation of World War II. Think about it. The only option he was left with was 1948 Olympics. And by the time 1948 came, he was 38 years of age. Can you imagine waiting for 10 years from 1938 to 1948 just for a moment to fulfill your dream? He did. And to everybody's surprise, he won. The Hungary won the 1948 Olympics rapid fire pistol shooting round. And not just 1948, but again, consequently in 1952, he won again the rapid fire pistol shooting challenge. Let me go back to the start. All of us aspire to one himself. Have a house, have a car, have a good partner, and have a good life. But when you are faced with difficult situations, what do you say to yourself? Do you say, why me? inspire me. You don't have to worry about what you are gone through. You just let them go and try to do anything. Try to struggle with the only option that you are left with. I'm emotional as it is. This is it. We all have too many different stories, so many special stories, and all of us aspire to become something. My message to all of you is, don't ask why to, ask why. That's it.